port lost momentum, and the city, which was so dependent upon it, was stricken. Its source of revenue had dried up, and now it had to try to live on outside help.
Because really, a lot of Liverpool's problems reflect wider economic changes that have been taking place. The way that the British economy has been changing, the way the international economy has been changing. A lot of the decisions that have affected the decline of Liverpool have been taken outside Liverpool and even outside this country, in the boardrooms of Detroit and so on. So really, if you're talking about the wider scale, the changes have got to come at the level of national government or even international issues, the way the multinational companies operate. Policy to move out to other places where labour is cheaper, to concentrate production elsewhere than on Merseyside, and we've seen that happen time and time again. Big companies closing down their operations here and moving elsewhere, very often to other countries, to Spain or other cheap labour parts of Europe, or to the Far East. The financial problems that people experience are reflected in the rate of electricity and gas disconnections that are taking place. People just can't afford to pay the bills, fuel bills, adequately clothe their children, and so on. And it affects other aspects of family budgeting, buying food. There's evidence now that children are not being fed adequately. I noticed only the other day in the window of the Community Health Council in the city centre, they're launching a new campaign against rickets. Now that's something that we thought we'd eradicated after the social welfare reforms after the Second World War, but now it's back with us.
Help, I need somebody. Help, not just anybody. Help me.
Liverpool is the shape of the future for many other places. Liverpool is their future here now. This is what happens when industry that we've relied on for so long in the past goes into serious decline. And what we are facing now, not just in Liverpool but throughout Western economies, is a long-term decline of manufacturing industry. And particularly, of course, the growth of new technology, which means we need far fewer people to work with their hands and brains. So really, Liverpool raises all kinds of questions about work and the position of work in our lives, and if people can't get work, how are they to be supported financially?